Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cuban. In this video, we're going to talk about page level security and can you even do that in Power BI? Everyone seems to be asking. Let's go. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. All right, page level security. This question keeps coming up. Patrick actually talked about this in a video he did a while back about row level security and object level security, but it's kind of buried, right? So if you just search for page level security, you're not going to find it. So in this video, I want to explicitly look at page level security and what your options are. Short answer is no. A different answer is maybe it depends. I don't know. Enough all this talking. You know we like to do it here in Guy in a Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my computer. So I've got Power BI Desktop here. Let me show you what your option is here and then explain why this is not page level security, but it gives you the feel of it. We go into my model. I've got a disconnected table that lists every page within side of the report. There are different ways you can do this. You could use dynamic row level security. You could have it on different items. There are a lot of different approaches to doing that. To keep things simple, just to explain how this works, I'm just using two fields that I'm going to drive role level security off of. So either execs or back office, this is going to align to my roles in role level security. So now what I've got is I've got a slicer that's just going off of that page name field with inside of the pages table, easy peasy. And then I've got a button that's using navigation based on whatever my selection is. So it's being driven by a measure using conditional formatting. And when I click on that, it takes me to the relevant page. Cool. Now what I've done is I've gone ahead and I've included some roles here. So I created two roles, back office and execs. And all I'm doing is filtering that page to say, look, is it true on that column? Meaning they can see the page. If it's yes, cool, we'll show it in the slicer. If not, then so on and so forth. Same thing for exec. And basically what this is gonna control is what they see in this slicer dropdown. Every other page outside of the overview page is hidden. So my Texas and Georgia pages. So that's the magic. Now, just like a good cooking show, I've published this to the Power BI service. And when we go in there, we can see I've got role level security set up for both roles. So let me go and test this role. It's going to go into the report and I'm viewing it as the back office role. And so what we can see here, again, all the pages are here, but you'll notice I don't have my page navigation here because it's only the overview page. So if I go to Texas, bam, I go to Texas. I can go back to overview, bam. Back to overview, right? So everything there is cool. Now let me go to the exec role, we'll apply that. And now you'll see that now the Texas and Georgia pages are not listed here and I can't get to them. So is this page level security? No, it's not. There's a word I like to use for this. It's called obfuscation. You're hiding things. And from an average user just clicking about, they're gonna be like, I can't get to it. Not a big deal. However, there are ways you can get to this page. So from the URL, you'll see that there's a given report section here, right? So I'm on the overview page. If we go back to back office and we go here and we go to Texas, you'll notice that there's a specific link in the URL here. If I just put that in the browser, there's nothing stopping me from getting the page. The only thing is it's not in that dropdown list. And so it's not easy to discover, but if they get that URL, they can hit the page. The other piece where this could bubble up if you're not careful and trying to implement this is drill through. And so if you're drill throughing to a different page, it's not gonna honor whatever you have in that given page selection for RLS, because it's an actual page there and Power BI is just gonna go to the page. So if there are things on that page that you don't want someone to look at, don't do this. Separate that out into a different report and then govern access to that given report. The bigger thing here though too, is make sure the data is controlled. So if there is security around data, row level security will absolutely secure the data. It just doesn't secure the page. I hope this just clears this up for you. There is an idea item. I've got it linked in the description below. If you wanna go vote it up, it's got a lot of votes already in terms of signaling that this is definitely a feature you would like to enable inside of Power BI. I've seen this in the context of just general page in reports, as well as like app experiences and being able to do that at a page level as well. There's definitely use cases for it. I'm not disagreeing with that, but today in the product, there is no concept of page level security. Only row level or object level security at the data layer. And then obviously access to the given reports. All right, let me know what you think. Did you think this was security? And now you're like, oh, I guess it's not. Let me know in the comments below, or if obfuscation was a new word for you. Let me know down below. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button, smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.